Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you a little TIG welding technique on a tin wall or SCAD 10 in this case. This is 6 inch stainless pipe 304. So I'm gonna prep it, clean in and out, make it really nice and shiny, no contamination. As you can see, the pipe is really dirty. A little bit of bevel, feather edge. You can leave a 16 of a land if you prefer. Lots of people do that just to prevent internal undercuts. And I'm gonna show you how to weld the technique that I'm using. Lots of people got issue the size of the rod to pick, the width of the gap. I'm gonna go with a loose 1/8, as you can see here. I'm gonna go loose 1/8, I'm gonna cup size 6. I'm gonna walk the cup, I like cup size 6, fits perfectly inside that bevel. This is pretty much the reference I like for the gap as well. Spread the pipes to enough to fit my nozzle in, and this is the tacks, just bridge tacks. They're not pretty, it doesn't matter, there's a reason why I like to do that. I was just tacking 332 with 75 amps, so you don't burn through or you don't have any sugar inside. It's just to keep those two coupons together. Okay, there's a couple ways you can freehand the bottom, which I do sometimes. Or you can just feed like a back feed it from the top and up to the sides. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna walk the cup on the bottom section. I'm gonna do the bottom first, one side, 6 to 9 o'clock and 6 to 3 o'clock. And from the top, I'm gonna go just dipping technique or We'll see when I start welding. It's always changing. Usually I got a plan and then I end up doing something else. That's how you got to do. That's why you got to adjust yourself to the situation. It's not always as we plan. So this is the bottom. I'm just back fitting from the top. Walk the cup. As I show you, it's a 70 amps. You can even maybe go out. This is 1/8 rod. So try to keep that rod, as that's why I like back fitting, especially on the top. Just keep the rod on top of that puddle, stretch that puddle. Watch up for your travel speed. You don't want to pause too much. It's going to open up very fast, as this is CAT 10. You want to keep an eye on your heat affected zone as well. Okay, so this is the bottom part. The purge is good. I set up around 30. It's around 15 liters per minute. Okay, this is the bottom part. Now I'm gonna go up on the side, close to that tack. On a 3 o'clock, just gonna keep that rod inside. Grind it out. Grind stop starts. It's not a big deal. If you put a little bit of air inside from the grinder, just close it again. Keep it for maybe a minute or two, just in case, to purge out all that oxygen that you put with your grinder. Preheat. Always go back a little bit, at least half inch. Wait a little bit until your puddle starts liquid enough, and then just add the rod and keep it there. The big thing with a 308 rod is you gotta really keep it close to your purge zone from your nozzle, or try to keep it right in the puddle. As soon as you pull it out, it's kind of reconnecting, is it's a little bit like contaminated, so you're gonna have a hard time reestablishing that nice liquid puddle again. Again, now this is a one side, both sides from 6 to 8 and from 6 to 5 o'clock. Now I'm gonna go up on 3 o'clock, close to that tack, and to remove what I said on beginning, why I like those kind of tacks, I'm just gonna use a Cubitron, or you can use a flapper disc as well. And as soon as you clean, there's no any marks, any indication there was any tack here. Prefer it more than put a bridge rod inside. As I said, it's a SCAD 10. So for the side, I'm gonna go down on 60 amps, and try to go on the side, try to keep it slightly inside that bevel, from the inside of that edge. And as soon as I pass 3 o'clock mark, I'm gonna pull it out and do the dipping technique. As I said, I already on the top part, I already passed 3 o'clock mark, so I'm going up to 12 or up to 1 o'clock. I'm just gonna dip or a keyhole technique, whatever you like to call it. As I said, for the bottom section, that which is most important, especially on a SCAD 10, you don't wanna sag down, you don't wanna set up a big perch to push all that puddle when you're welding. That's why a 1/8 and back feet technique for the bottom section, and for the top section, that's easy. It's gravity plays the role. You can even go up on the purge, especially on the top section, so it's gonna form that root really nice. Okay, this is the other side, so I'm gonna remove that tack. I welded up to that tack, so that what's gonna happen, it's gonna close. As you can see now, that you can fit 1/8 rod inside. As soon as I remove that tack, and it, because it's still hot, it's gonna shrink. It's gonna shrink perfectly for the, you can't fit 1/8 anymore, which will be too much for 1/8, because for the bottom section I like 3/32, and I'm gonna switch to 3/32, and I'm gonna, for that little part, I'm gonna keep that rod inside. I'm still on 60 amps. Keep that rod inside, and as soon as it starts shrinking even more, I'm just gonna pull it out and continue with, you can dab or keyhole it. There you go, now it shrink. Now I just pull it out, and I'm just gonna keep with the dabbing all the way up to 11 o'clock on this side. As I said, SCAD 10, it's a little bit tricky, you know. It's not a big deal. You need to practice, you need to work with them. The last I did was like a couple of years ago, and I didn't do since then, and I find it work a piece of pipe, so I said, okay, let's go. I'm gonna do one video for you guys. And it's good for me as well, because as I said, you don't use it, you lose it, you know. Okay, so this is done, clean for your cap. There's a lots of meat here, for no need, guys, for any hot pass. It doesn't matter if you still got below that surface your root pass, you can start capping right away. And this is the root from the bottom up on the side. I just have one spot up on a tie-in as I was going downhill from 12 to 11 o'clock. This little bit tie-in connection is not the best, but it's good. This is a perfectly good root, and nothing's wrong with that, especially for SCAD 10. As I said, SCAD 10 is tricky, thin, and you have to have a gap. It's bevel. You just can. Okay, this is 81 amps for the capping, and this is 1/8 rod for capping. Watch out for your travel speed. You don't wanna go too slow. Just adjust yourself, you know, to the amps that you can handle. Don't turn off your purge as soon as you're done with your root. Keep it on. Let pipe to cool down, and keep the purge going, and do your cap, and that's it, pretty much. That's it for the cap. The cap is good and uniform. That's how the cap should look like. And it's a little bit tricky, as I said, with SCAT 10. Watch your heat, watch your travel speed, and clean your pipe. Make it clean. It's going to be easier for you to control that puddle, to manipulate that puddle. Hope you guys like it. Like, subscribe, share. And you guys, you got to burn to learn. There's no other way around. Keep up the good work, and see you in the next one, guys. Take care.